We will see some tips for simulation of closed loop system. Hi, this is Reddy. Examples for open loop system: a blind and deaf man driving a vehicle. You have given him some set speed, but he doesn't follow. A young man driving a bike. The father gives a set speed, but he doesn't follow that reference speed. Response of open loop system: there is an increase in the speed, but this blind man cannot observe. He'll continue to run at high speed. If this is the set speed and this is the actual speed, this difference is steady state error. How to create a step change in voltage when you do simulation? You use this circuit. Initially, S2 alone is on, S1 is off. If this alone is on, the voltage is V1. At some time, you are opening this switch and closing this switch. So when S1 is on and S2 is off, V1 and V2 comes in series. So total voltage is V1 plus V2. This is how we create step change in input voltage. Examples for closed loop system: air conditioner. At home you give some set temperature, say 20 degrees. You are sleeping nicely, but the closed loop air conditioner maintains a temperature equal to the set temperature. Another example: constant speed bike. Father has given a bike to the daughter and told the daughter she should drive at 40 km/h, and we assume that she is very sincere and obedient. So she tries to maintain a speed of 40 km/h. So whenever speed increases, she'll reduce the acceleration. Whenever speed decreases, she'll increase the acceleration, such that she drives at constant speed. This is closed loop control of DC motor. You have a speed loop which maintains actual speed is equal to set speed. You have a current loop which gives protection to the rectifier and motor. So whatever correction you do, that correction must be opposite to the disturbance. If disturbance is applied in this direction, the current must be in the opposite direction. We use some controllers. PI controller is very popular. It is slow, but it has reduced steady state error. You have a proportional part and you have an integral part. Your pneumatic door closer in AC room is a mechanical PI controller. Because of this door closer, when you close the door gets closed very slowly. In PID controller, you have differential part additionally. PID is faster than PI. The overshoot will be less with PID. We'll see some MATLAB simulation results. If you click this subsystem, you find the two source circuit which will give change in input voltage. This is a PV inverter system. Output of PV is boosted. Output of the boost converter is applied to the inverter. So when there is an input voltage which increases, your inverter output also increases. Your response of open loop system: when PV input voltage increases, the output of the inverter also increases. In closed loop system, we sense the actual voltage. This is the reference voltage. Error, we give it to the PI controller. Output of the PI controller, we give to the comparator. Comparator gives updated pulses. These updated pulses are applied to the switches of the boost converter. Let us see what happens in this. You have a comparator which compares a triangular waveform, and this is the output of the PI controller. So output of the comparator will be a pulse. Now input voltage increases, output voltage increases, the error increases. So when the error increases, the new pulse width decreases. This you can compare with that analogy of daughter driving the scooter or bike. So when speed increases, what she will do is she will reduce the acceleration. Here when input voltage increases, we reduce the pulse width. So your closed loop response will be like this. Here the voltage increases, then your closed loop action comes into picture and voltage is brought back to the normal value. So this is response of closed loop system in MATLAB. Some examples for stability: a normal person is stable, but a drunkard person is unstable. Or a vertical cone, if you give small disturbances, it is stable, but a flat cone is marginally stable. An inverted cone is definitely unstable. When a disturbance is given, it falls down. So some tips for MATLAB simulation. Better to use a saturator at the output of PI or PID controller so that the pulses are applied in the starting or during transient period. When you are doing simulation of closed loop system, better to use the solver ODE23S. When you run, sometimes you get data logging and memory allocation errors. This can be minimized by increasing number of consecutive zero crossings. When you use many scopes, your simulation takes long time. Students generally make mistake in drain and source. So be careful with the connection of drain and source in a MOSFET. When you are simulating circuits with faults, it is better to use continuous mode. So we offer coaching for gate, EC and EEE branches. This is our website, victoryinshoot.in. We guide projects for BE EEE and MA PED students. If you find this video useful, please like, subscribe and share. Thank you for your patience, and we'll meet in the next video.